So far, we have been talking about the traditional recommendation systems. Now, as we told earlier, traditional recommendation systems assumes a linear relationship between the user and item interactions. However, when we get into a personalized mode, many often these interactions are not linear, and there are so many non-linear interactions which happens, and that's best captured by deep learning based recommendation systems. Now, there are different approaches for deep learning. Let's look at one of the first ones, which is based on the multi-layer perceptrons. Now, the basic inputs to this kind of recommendation systems are your latent vectors of the users. Now, it could be one hot encoding of all the users. And another input is the item vectors. You know, these vectors, the number of items which the customer prefers to interact with. You know, these are your basic inputs. You know, added to that, you can also add your context. Like say, for example, the day of the month or month in the year, the time in which the customer has interacted, what has been the past purchases of customers. So different types of context also you can add along with many of these vectors. So these becomes your inputs. And these inputs are then loaded into a typical multi-layer perceptrons with multiple layer and different types of, number of neurons. And the final, when you get into the training, you know, what is finally predicted is the probability of interactions. That is whether the customer is likely to buy or not. And so your training set gets into, or your label is actually whether the customer has actually bought it or not. So after a lot of your training, you get a score, kind of a rank, whether a particular product and a user, whether there is this probability of the customer likely to buy it or not. And so based on different types of items, you can rank which are these products which the customer is more likely to buy and then recommend them. So this is one of the basic problem setting for a deep learning based or multi-layer perceptron based recommendation systems. Now we'll see other deep learning based recommendation systems in the subsequent slides. So in the previous slide, we saw an approach of how multi-layer perceptrons can be used as a recommendation systems. Now, just like multi-layer perceptrons, you know, bigger deep learning models like your CNNs, RNNs, attention models, restricted Boltzmann models, or autoencoders, these are all can be used for deep learning based recommendation systems. And the premise is very kind of similar. You know, earlier we in the multi-layer perceptrons, we saw how the inputs were based on user inputs and or user vectors and item vectors and the context vectors, etc. Similarly, in many of these other approaches like your CNNs or RNNs, you can give different types of inputs, like say for example images or videos or audio files. So like your traditional CNN or RNN layers or RNN structures, it kind of extracts these lower level extractions or representations of data and then uses it for ranking these interactions between the products and the customers. And so that's the basic premise in many of these deep learning based recommendation systems. And as we mentioned earlier, deep learning recommendation systems are very good. Only place where it suffers is in terms of interpretability, or how do you really interpret many of these deep learning models which is being used as recommendation systems is where it suffers. And also when you get into a more personalized space and adapting to individual tastes becomes very important. And that's where many approaches like your reinforcement learning approaches started getting used in making recommendation system. So we will dive into recommendations into reinforcement learning, for example, because before we get into reinforcement learning based recommendation systems, let's take a small primer on what reinforcement learning is in the subsequent slide.